Skilling in old school RuneScape can be fun. However, this is not an opinion that the majority of the player base shares. And I believe one of the reasons for that is that most aren't equipped with the right knowledge. And what happens when you don't have all the info needed to do a certain task? It is likely that you are not very good at doing said task. And what happens when you're not good at something? You can start to dislike it, especially when it feels you are being forced to do it. And I am saying forced here since a lot of content is locked behind skilling requirements. If it's an elite achievement diary that you're after, or maybe a master clue step, or maybe that skilling cape perk you always wanted, you will need to skill to achieve those. And I agree, sitting on your hands, staring a hole in your monitor for 2 weeks at the motherlode mine isn't fun. But what if you could improve your clicks, learn new engaging methods, save a lot of time, and enjoy the process as well? And my goal with this video is not to tell everyone how to play the game, but I do want to show that learning new methods and getting better at them can be rewarding in itself, and that there doesn't need to be an incentive in the form of a powerful reward after you clawed your way through a skill. And in this video I want to share some basic tips to smoothen the skilling experience, in-game in the form of settings and plugins, and out-of-game as well. This will not be a guide for all skills or methods, I will make those in the future. Alright, enough of this intro, let's get into the video. A question I get asked a lot is, how can you do X method for so long without getting wrist or hand issues? And this is a fair question, since a lot of the skilling methods do require a lot of repetitive actions, and that can put some strain on the wrist for some people. To address this, I wanted to go over some things you can do outside of the game to improve your in-game performance, help prevent wrist or hand pains, or any other discomforts. First, I wanted to say that the points I am about to list are things that really help me personally. And since everybody is different, these may or may not work for you. However, please go over them and decide for yourself if you can improve on the following points. Alright, first up, use a good mouse for your hands. For me personally, this was a huge game changer. I have pretty big hands, and in the past I've been using mice that were way too small for my hands, causing all kinds of issues. And the mouse I'm currently using is a SteelSeries Rival 300. It's a pretty big mouse and it weighs 130 grams, so almost like twice as heavy as most mice today. And I've been using this for the vast majority of my 200 mil all grind. But getting the right size mouse isn't all you can do to improve your clicks and endurance. It's also very important to be on a DPI that works for you. And I'm just gonna say it, you are probably on a too high DPI. I would suggest switching to 600 to 800 DPI for old school RuneScape. This results in more accurate clicks and also less strain on the wrist, since the very tiny and cramped movements that you need to make with high DPI, those can be the source of wrist pain for many. So find a good mouse that fits your hand and adjust the DPI accordingly. Secondly, having good posture while playing is very important. But there are three things I want to point out here that again really helped me. Align the height of your chair so that when you're sitting, your forearm is horizontal on your desk, so no angle in the wrist. And I'm a big fan of armrests for this. Be sure to make them the same height as your desk though, so you can keep the horizontal forearm. And the way how I have it, is I place my elbow next to my body on the armrest and then extend my arm slightly outwards and grab my mouse. It is also important to keep your hand and forearm in one line, like this. When playing, I only use my wrist or fingers to move the mouse. But my starting position always remains the same, because already having an angle in your wrist will put unnecessary strain on it. And lastly, having your monitor or main client at the same height as your eyes, so you don't have to look up or down, which can cause strain on the neck. A simple way to achieve this is by elevating your monitor with an object or a mount. Another couple things you can do are using Flux or Windows Nightlight for less strain on your eyes. Staying hydrated while playing. Make sure to always have a drink, preferably water, next to you. And finally, take breaks when needed and stretch when you start feeling discomfort. In my opinion, the best way to prevent injury or any other issues is to also be active during the day. Doesn't matter if that's building a strong grip in the gym or just going for walks every morning. Your body will thank you when you take care of it. Now moving on to the in-game settings. Most of you are probably still logging in like this, where you click existing user and type in your email and password. Around a year ago, JAGX released their official launcher. You can find a download link on the homepage of the Old School RuneScape website. After downloading it and creating your own JAGX account, you are met with this screen. You can add all your RuneScape accounts to it via the Manage Accounts. Then select an account you want to play with. Select the launcher you want to play from. You can start a RuneLite or an official client. And then press play. And now you can log in with just one click. The default client size and settings when creating your account look like this. Kind of clunky in my opinion. It looks like your character isn't even in the middle of the screen. And I can see why many people play on a larger client because of that. For most skills, it is beneficial to play on resizable modern. So shrink down your clients and select resizable modern in the settings tab. You can already see we have a lot more space over here. But you still want to play on the smallest client size possible, since having your inventory closer to where you want to click saves a lot of mouse movement, resulting in fewer misclicks and less strain on your wrist slash hand. If you still prefer fixed mode, that is completely fine, but I still highly suggest you try out resizable modern. But please, no more Fortnite-sized clients with tiny UI while being zoomed out to space. However, using stretch mode can be an option for those with high-resolution monitors, but making your client too big can impact the use of alternate accounts negatively, since again, more mouse movement that way. For some methods, a slightly bigger client can be beneficial, for the likes of Construction, Driftnet or Sepulcher. To further customize your client, you want to click on the All Settings button. Then go to the search bar and just copy what I am doing now. Type in chatbox and enable the transparent chatbox option, but make sure also the click-through transparent chatbox is enabled. Then move the scroll bar position to the left to prevent misclicking on it while skilling. Then hide roofs. Enable moving the camera with the middle mouse button. Shift-click to drop items. Now type in escape. And tick the box so we can close the current interface with pressing escape. This is very helpful for a lot of skilling methods that involves a bank. Then move the follower option lower down so you don't misclick on your pet or follower. Also rebinding your hotkeys to a place where you can easily access them. Like the side buttons of your mouse. That's what I'm using. And I suggest you rebind your inventory, your spellbook and your gear tab to a key that works for you, since those are most frequently used during skilling. Then type in trade and turn off accept trade delay for when you're doing something that involves a lot of trading, like runecrafting with runners, or maybe just trading with your alt. And then lastly, open the settings of your XP drops by right-clicking it. The size doesn't really matter, but I like them on largest. But putting the speed on slower can really help learn tick manipulation, since the timing of the XP drops can be used to keep track of the ticks. And I'd like to turn off the progress bar, since it looks a bit cleaner and you're just not gonna stare at it until the goal is complete. And grouping the XP drops also makes it a little bit more clean. And you can also turn off the XP counter if you don't want to be distracted by anything at all. And I would say our client looks much better than what we started with. Now I wanted to talk about a couple general plugins. I'm not gonna go over every specific plugin for all the skills. I will do that in the specific skill video guides. Of course, everyone is free to install and use whatever plugin they want, but some of them are, in my opinion, not very useful and just clutter the screen for zero. If you are not a defense or attack pure, I would highly suggest you turn off attack styles. Also, the ammo plugin doesn't really do anything to have on all the time. I would say the daily task indicator is also somewhat useless. And this isn't RS3, so please turn off the mouse tooltips. And also the item stats plugin is just putting so much useless information on your screen for zero. And these status bars just take up the space we just freed with like setting up our client. So please turn those off. And for seeing your XP progress and skills, you can just open the skilling tab and see your XP an hour and everything, and just don't have this weird ass looking plugin called Skill Progress Bars enabled. Makes it look a lot cleaner. Another very commonly used plugin I see are the XP globes. I would suggest turning these off, since seeing the visible progress on screen can be demotivating at times. But if you still want to have it on screen, I would suggest right-clicking the skill you want to have displayed, then add to canvas, and then you can see all the useful information displayed on the screen as well, instead of these weird-ass globes. And after killing this goblin, I want to address probably the worst offender of cluttering the screen, and that is ground items. The plugin itself is very useful, and I highly suggest you use it, but there are some things you can tweak in the plugin to make it even better. When pressing Alt, a small minus and plus button appear next to the item. Click the minus one to hide it, click the plus one to highlight the item. You can also hold Alt and drag your inventory, minimap, and chatbox, and just simply right-click to reset it again. This can be beneficial for some skills, however, I personally don't really use it. Only the minimap moving is something I sometimes use. Now back to the ground items. And I see so many people with the GE price and the high AUG price next to every single item for no reason. And it looks really bad if you have a lot of items on the ground, completely like filling the screen with random numbers. So what I suggest you do is to put the price display menu on off, because you already see your expensive drops coming in the chat box most likely. So there's no need to have all the prices on the screen, and it just looks much nicer when you just see the item name. And a quick way to hide a lot of low value items is to put the hide under value to something like 2000 or 5000 GP, so you just have all the very low value items just instantly hidden. And with a lot of the same low value items on the ground, sometimes it can be hard to pick up the higher value items like during Slayer. A way to fix this is to click the collapse ground item menu, and that way all the items will be stacked and showing a number next to it. Now a couple Runelite plugins that are very useful. Menu Entry Swapper, probably one of the most overpowered plugins that you can find on base Runelite. With the customizable left or shift click, you can hold shift, right click, and then you can swap the left click option to anything you want for every item, making it very useful for tick manipulation, so you can have the mahogany lock and the knife on use and have the teak lock on drop. With this you can also change the options around your bank, so you can fill your runecrafting pouches from the bank, drink stamina from the bank and equip jewelry, making runecrafting very easy. Utilizing the anti-drag plugin is also very beneficial to having good clicks, since dragging around items in your inventory can be very annoying. I would suggest putting the drag delay somewhere around 15, so you still can drag items with a slight delay, but nothing too crazy. But it will still prevent you from dragging items while doing high intensity methods. Entity hider to hide NPCs and players, so you don't misclick. Also in entity hider you can hide dead NPCs, which can be also very nice. Tile indicators to show your true tile of your character. It's very helpful for doing any skilling that involves any type of movement. And of course your ground markers to highlight tiles. By clicking this button all the way at the bottom of the settings, you can go to the plugin hub. And in here you can find all sorts of plugins for anything you like basically. But there are some very helpful plugins in here, and I will go over a couple ones very briefly. Bank tag layouts to create handy skilling tabs without having to reorganize your whole bank. Custom menu swaps is also very helpful. With this you can swap around menu options. So you can have like the dismiss option on random events as the first one, except for the genie if you type in this. And you can also hide options by typing in the custom hide. And with this you can hide the option to pick flags, for example, when you're doing Prisoner's rooftops, or remove the ability to sit on mahogany benches while doing construction. And in the plugin hub you can also find the tick tracker plugin. This one is pretty useful to see if the world that you are on is actually decent, because having the ping displayed isn't really telling you like how good the world is. But this tick tracker plugin is counting all the ticks on the world, and then it's giving you a percentage of the amount of ticks that are good. And what this means is that sometimes a tick can be longer or shorter than 0.6 seconds. And that can be very annoying if the ticks aren't consistent, when you need to time your clicks very precisely. But at the moment it is Sunday evening, so the servers are not very good. And my FPS is also kind of low, since I'm having like 8 clients open for my Slayer stuff for the speedrun. And I'm recording at the same time, so the FPS is kind of tanking. But usually you want to aim for around 90% or higher for on the world. And if it's like below 80, you definitely want to get off that world. Also, to get a ping in the top right of your client, you go to the World Hopper plugin and click the box show world ping. to get the FPS on the screen, you type in FPS control and turn that on and tick the box, draw FPS indicator. I also briefly wanted to talk about Visual Metronome. This is a fairly new plugin, at least to me. And maybe this can help learning tick manipulation, since you can put a tick count to anything that you want to do with like the tick manipulation. If it's doing like two tick ticks, you can put it on two, or three tick mining, you can put it on three. And with this, maybe you can count the ticks a little bit better without having to hear the monotone sound of the normal metronome. So I don't know, maybe this is a good one. I've never used it, but I think it can be helpful for some. But that is all I had to share with you guys today. Hopefully you learned a thing or two, or found it entertaining. Please let me know in the comments if you have any feedback or suggestions. I will make all guides for all skills or skilling methods that need more explanation in the future. And the next video in this like kind of mini series on how to become a better skiller, I will be talking about alts mainly. And have a good morning, afternoon, or evening wherever you are in the world. And I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.